two teams compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board, and every point is worth $5. The points are doubled in round three, and then tripled in round four. The team with the most points at the end of round four play for a jackpot of $5,000! Ghana, it's time to play Family Feud! Give it up for Steve Harvey!
Yeah. Appreciate that. Thank y'all. Yeah, man. Yeah. Welcome to Family Feud, Ghana, everybody. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Yeah. It's gonna get it working, man. I'm in, man. I'm all the way in. Look, we got a good one. This is the way the game works. Our researchers have been out on the streets of Ghana, and they've been asking for some answers to some really simple questions. We got all those answers locked into this game board behind me. All these families got to do is guess what those answers are, and the person that guesses the most answers gets the most points. Whoever ends up with the most points gonna walk out of here with some serious money today, man. Yeah. So you ready to meet the families, everybody? See, yeah.
Yeah.
From Greater Accra, it's the Girl Power family. Yeah. Yeah. All right now, careful. And from Takoradi, it's the KOOMSON family. Yeah. Hey, listen. We're gonna have a good one today. Somebody's gonna have a chance to play at this jackpot of $5,000. So, if you're ready to play Feud, everybody say yeah.
Yeah!
Give me Angel, give me Max.
Hey, baby.
All right, welcome to the show. Here we go. Surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
A nurse.
A nurse.
We gonna play, baby.
We gonna play. All right, let's go. All right, got the girl power team over here. What do you do?
I am an interior decorator and also a director of a children's home where I basically provide food, clothing, shelter, and education. I like to call them the privileged children, but the underprivileged children in Accra.
How'd y'all come up with the name Girl Power?
Well, the future is female, Steve, and you know it.
No, you know, in my world, girls is now.
Well, right now. The future is now, Steve.
Yeah, well, the girls have been in my heart since I was born.
Oh, yeah.
I wanted a girlfriend when I was in kindergarten.
Wow.
I love women. It's the greatest invention of all time. The female. Oh. All right, Angel, introduce your team.
Okay, so this is Alex. She's a projects manager. This is Nadia, who's a fashion designer. And Beatrice is a travel consultant.
Are you single?
Single and ready to flamingo, baby.
Single and ready to flamingo.
Flamingo.
Are you single?
I'm single.
Wow. Wow. How old are you?
28.
You're 28? I thought she was about 19.
Oh, thank you.
I'll take it as a compliment.
28. Little fine little thing. Well, I have some sons.
Oh, send them my way.
Send them our way.
Oh, you single too?
Yeah, I'm single.
What about you?
Single.
Single?
Single.
Yeah. See, let me tell you how smart God is. God gave me the life that I have today when I was older. Because he knew if he had given this to me when I was 30, all of them would be in trouble. So God made me older and wiser. You ready to play, Alex?
I'm very ready.
Yeah. Name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
A shopping attendant?
Good answer.
A shopping attendant. Oh. Nadia, how are you?
Hi, I'm good.
What do you do?
I'm a fashion designer.
Oh, you design clothes?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
And I sew as well.
Oh, yeah, for women?
Yeah, and men.
Oh, men too, okay.
I'll see you after the show to take your measurement.
No, you won't see me after the show.
Why not?
No. I'll see you right after the show. Oh, no. Yes. 30 years ago, I'll see you after the show. You better believe it. All right, you ready to play?
Mm-hmm.
Name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
My answer is a waiter or a waitress.
A waiter or a waitress. Hello, Beatrice.
Hello, Uncle Steve.
How are you, darling? I'm wonderful. Good. You're a travel agent?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so you book, like what?
Packages, tour packages in Ghana. If you want to go to Cape Coast, anywhere, I can do that for you.
I'm balling, you know, I'm a baller, so.
We like it.
You know, when you're balling, you know, you gotta have, you know, I want like everything. I want the big sweets, I want the butler, you know. I'ma need the chef.
Okay.
You know, I gotta have drivers.
Oh, right.
You know what I mean? I just got to be just all pimped out.
You don't have your problem.
Okay, all
right. Just come.
Just call you.
Yeah.
I can't. What y'all keep talking about? I'll see you after the show. Just call me. I can't do nothing. I have some people who can call you.
Really? Okay.
No, like, you know, like, I have a person, like, that's in charge of me and my wife's travel. And so they call.
Travel person call me. Okay.
That's fine.
Are you get it? Mm-hmm. I don't go to hear something too.
Okay.
It's intuitive. You have to block this. It's a call this on the road.
No problem.
No problem.
Yet that call me anytime.
Beauty.
For you?
Can you speak Ga?
No, I speak Tree.
You speak Tree.
Yeah.
Who speaks Ga? I'll be over there in a minute. Going over there and talk to my girl over there. See, I don't know Tree.
Oh, really?
I don't know Tree. No, I know Ga. I don't know Tree.
Wow. I'm sad, but I'll teach you Tree.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, let's play.
Okay.
Name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
The bank, the tellers.
The bank. Yeah. Angel, name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
I'd say a mechanic.
A mechanic. All right. We got two strikes. We got to be careful. Coomson family can steal. This little girl, the cute little girl. Ooh, I got a son for you. Yeah, girl. What do you say you do again?
I'm a project manager.
Oh, yeah, you ain't got to do that no more. Yeah. Name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
Whew, okay. I'm a little nervous, but I'm going to say... Oh, just let my head. Airport, person that works at the airport.
Person that works at the airport.
Good answer, yeah.
Oh, no.
Name a job where you would need to wear a name tag.
I'll say a security personnel.
A security personnel. Yes! 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 Number seven. Five. Four.
Police officer.
Well, we're playing Feud now. Girl power not on the board. KOOMSON family got 54. Don't go away, we'll be right back. We're playing Family Feud. Back to Family Feud, everybody. Girl power not on the board. KOOMSON family 54. Give me Alex. Give me Rebecca. Okay, little Alex. Okay. You ain't 18 no more. Okay. All right, ladies, we surveyed 100 people. Top six answers on the board. Name a reason why someone would make fun of your shoes.
It's torn.
It's torn.
It's ugly.
They're ugly.
They're gonna play.
Max, how you doing, man?
Good, Steve.
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm a farmer.
Oh, a farmer. Oh, okay, good. Yeah. So, I'm gonna take a guess now. Cocoa beans there. Are you that?
No.
Okay. Are you a pineapple farmer?
No.
The pineapples in Ghana are a different color than what they have in the States. Mm. They're very yellow. Almost off-white.
Yeah.
So sweet, man. Best pineapples in the world. Am I telling the truth?
True. True.
Okay, so you're not pineapples, you don't do cocoa beans. Let's see. Sugar.
No.
That's big in Ghana, too.
It is.
All right, I'm naming all the big stuff. So let's just, since you ain't farming big stuff, let's go to little stuff.
No, there's one more big stuff in Ghana.
There's one more big thing in Ghana?
You've not mentioned it.
Sugar, I'm not gonna mention it. Rice.
Yeah. Yes, Steve.
Rice.
I'm a rice farmer.
Yeah. There you go. Almost forgot. Yeah, that's good. So how long you been farming, man?
About a year now.
My goal is, when I retire, I've always wanted a greenhouse, because I grew up on a farm.
Ooh, you're in the right place, man.
A greenhouse?
Yeah.
I just wanted the size of this stage, covered indoor, misters, create my own rain, have my own lights.
We're gonna do that.
Yeah. I want just a greenhouse. I just want to grow herbs.
Yeah.
Dill, thyme, rosemary.
Lettuce.
Just that, you know, a couple of vegetables, maybe some tomatoes, maybe a little cucumber and some cabbage.
You're in the right place, Steve.
Okay, good.
Because we got a greenhouse farmer here too.
Huh?
Isaac is a greenhouse farmer.
He's a greenhouse farmer?
Yeah.
And I distribute
your
rice.
Shut up. Isaac, you a greenhouse farmer?
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not a huge thing in Africa now, but it's a very good technology. So during my last year in school, we went for a competition. That's where my interest grew. And then, yeah, so we are starting up a greenhouse, two of them actually, and it's part of it.
Because it's not really big. See, you gotta get into greenhouse farming because it stops you from being affected so much by the weather.
Yeah.
And so many farmers' crops get wiped out because of drought or excessive rain or pests.
About 30% of them, actually, yeah.
I'm gonna invest in that.
Yeah.
Yes, Steve.
For sure, Steve.
Yes, Steve.
For sure, Steve.
Yes,
Steve. Yeah. 100% welcome.
All right, Max, introduce everybody.
So we have Rebecca, we have Isaac and Eleanor, great friends.
Oh, okay, great friends. Rebecca, what do you do?
I'm a student. I study geological engineering.
Oh, I ain't want to do that. I'm not waking up every day to study no damn rock.
But the deal in go-to.
I know rocks are everything.
Huh?
Rocks are everything.
Rocks are everything?
Yeah. We build with rock.
You build with rock?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then we build on rock.
Then you build on the rock?
Uh-huh. And then we build in rock.
And you...
Build in
build
rock?
Build in rock.
Oh, you build with rock?
With, on, and in.
Oh, you build in rock?
Yeah.
Yay.
Yay.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Yes, please. Okay, I understand. All right, let's go, Isaac. Name a reason why someone would make fun of your shoes.
The shoes look dirty.
They look dirty.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Yeah! Eleanor, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
What do you do, darling?
I'm a baker and a rice distributor.
Come on, now we're talking. Now we're talking. Bacon, baby. What's your favorite? What are you famous for baking?
Cakes.
Cakes?
Yes, birthday cakes.
It's my birthday. Where my damn cake?
I actually wanted to bake, but looking at the weather, it might get messed up.
You owe me a cake.
No problem. No problem.
Now, do you want to know what my favorite cake is?
Tell me.
Now, girl.
Tell me. Talk to me.
Listen to me.
Talk to me.
When my mother was living, all the way up till I was 40 years old, every birthday, my mother made me a German chocolate cake. I don't care where I was in the world, my mother made sure I got that cake for my birthday. I would open
Done.
Up the box,
Done.
German chocolate cake.
Done.
My mother died
with
23 years ago.
With whipped cream or butter?
Don't you put no whipped cream on the cake.
So what you want on it?
But see, Marjorie, when I married Marjorie, God sent me a woman who made German chocolate cake to taste exactly
like
the
mom's.
Way my mother made it.
God bless her. God bless her.
I could not believe it. So I don't put that pressure on you. Do you make red velvet cake?
Yes, please.
Okay, make me red velvet cake, because I don't want that pressure. Yeah, I don't want to put that pressure on you.
But I could do it.
Yeah, but I love red velvet, too. So if you make that, it won't be no pressure.
Fine.
Beautiful. Are you married?
No, please, but
you
I'm
can
engaged.
Cook. You are engaged?
Yes.
Oh. Name a reason why someone would make fun of your shoes.
Steve, someone would laugh at me because my shoes may be crooked.
Good answer, good answer.
My shoes may look crooked.
I have no idea what that means, but they look crooked. Only one strike, Max. Name a reason why someone would make fun of your shoes.
Well, Steve, because they're oversized.
They're oversized. Yeah. Hey, Rebecca, give me a reason why someone would make fun of your shoes.
If their shoes are too small.
Too small.
Yeah. Good answer.
All right, we got two strikes. Isaac, gotta be careful. Girl power can steal. Name a reason why someone will make fun of your shoes.
If you don't have lace on, they are not laced.
Good answer, good answer.
Good answer.
If they don't what?
They are not laced, the shoes are
They're
not
laced. They're not laced.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
You don't have laces on.
Good answer.
Oh, laces.
Yeah.
Oh, laces. They don't have laces. Ladies, name a reason why someone would make fun of your shoes.
I'm gonna say they're fake.
They are fake. Number four. That was round two, everybody. We got a game now. Girl Power got 69. KOOMSON family got 54. Yeah, we got a good one now. Don't go away. After the break, family's gonna be playing for double points. Yeah, we in Ghana, man. Hey, what's up, Kevin? Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a game now. It done tightened up. Girl Power got 69. KOOMSON Family got 54. Give me Nadia, give me Isaac. All right, here we go. This round, we've doubled the points, surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board. If a stranger calls you Charlie, what are they about to ask you?
How far?
Huh?
How far?
How far?
How are you?
How are you?
Yeah.
You ain't the same. How are you? Pass or play?
Yeah, play.
Okay, let me ask you something. When you say how far, what does that mean?
It means how are things going?
Oh, I thought you was, you know, I'm trying to go to the hospital. How far is that?
No.
I was finna say, what the hell are you asking how far? You ain't even told him where you're going yet. Okay, Eleanor, if a stranger calls you Charlie, okay, what is Charlie?
Charlie, like your buddy, your friend.
Your buddy, your
yeah.
friend. Okay. If a stranger calls you, hey, hey, buddy, what are they about to ask you?
You dead.
Are you dead?
Good answer.
Are you dead? You dead.
You dead.
You dead.
Y-O-U-D-E-Y. You dead.
You dead.
You dead.
Oh,
are you there?
Are you there? You dead. Like, it's been a while, so Charlie, you dead.
I thought you said, are you dead? And I was going, well, hell, he right there. And are you dead? Are you dead? Max, if a stranger calls you Charlie, what are they about to ask you?
You chop? Have you eaten? Yeah.
Charlie, you chop?
You chop. All right, we got two strikes. Girl Power can steal. Come on, Rebecca, you're a good player. If a stranger calls you Charlie, what are they about to ask you?
Charlie, what are they going?
Growing?
What's they go
what
on?
What they go on?
What they go on?
Like, what's going on?
Wow.
It's pidgin English.
Oh, it's pidgin?
Yeah.
Now, I don't speak pidgin. I speak Ga. You speak Ga, right?
Yeah.
So now, go ahead. Go ahead, Tessie.
Ke polo chebu chale te oba mini eba ni babi.
No. Te eba.
Te eba bi. No,
T
is not correct.
No, I just told you. You gonna tell me? I speak God, man.
No.
Ke? I know, ke.
Polo.
Polo.
Chebwe. Ke polo chebwe chale. Te e bani babi bute.
Te, I said te. See, and then I say te, and then she said, no, te is not correct.
Te.
I told her it was te.
Steve.
I speak this. You don't even know
no,
what you're doing. I'm gonna go back over there and talk to that girl over there and speak tweet.
No.
Okay, go ahead, baby. Te.
Te oba.
Te oba, I know.
Te oba, we te. Steve.
Yes.
Te means how.
Te means
what
how.
What means mini.
Yes. That's right.
So if a stranger, ke umanfo chebo e.
Yeah, ke umanfo chebo
chale.
Ke umanfo chebo e chale. Te.
Ke umanfo chebo chale.
Te.
Mini. Mini. Mani ba bibu.
Mani du ba bubu. Ate chebo.
No.
Mani just say bubu te se. You are catching bragging. You are catching bragging.
He doesn't know what he's saying. Oh, my God.
Yeah, Cabo is it.
Woo, baby! Come on over.
If a stranger calls you Charlie, what are they about to ask you?
Steve, they're about to ask me for some directions.
Yes. Yes.
They're about to ask you for some directions. Number five. Cité.
It's many.
All right, okay. I'm just trying to help you out, baby. You know, you're young. You don't know everything. Number four. Catisse. Kebatisse.
Enyatra.
Three.
Ask for money.
No, please. All right, listen to me. Both teams, this is very important for both of you because both of you now have everything to play for. This game is close. Whoever has the most points at the end of this final round will go on to play for the jackpot of $5,000. Right now, Girl Power has 113. KOOMSON family got 54. Let's get it on. Give me Patrice, give me Eleanor. Ladies, points are tripled. Surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board. Name something people do when watching sports on TV.
Shout.
They shout. Yeah, let's go. Max, name something people do when they're watching sports on TV.
In Ghana, a lot of people argue when watching sports.
They argue. Rebecca, something people do when watching sports on TV.
Okay, in Ghana, they predict scores.
They predict scores?
Yeah.
Isaac, only one strike. Name something people do when watching sports on TV.
They say go.
Go! That took a lot out. I thought that was up there, Isaac. Oh. Kiachiopo. Here we go. Kiachiopo. Eon two cheeks. Glimba was can steal.
I understand everything.
I know you do, baby. The God.
Yeah, God. Pure God.
See, I go God, I put three languages together. I speak God, Twee and Pigeon.
That's right.
I put them all three together.
Yeah.
That
From
way,
Steve
no matter.
Language.
Yeah. See, that way, no matter who I'm talking to in Ghana, I'm gonna say something you know.
You. Yes, definitely. You pick something out.
See, cause who? How do you know? You meet a person in Ghana, you don't know if they speak Twee. You don't know if it's Ga or Pigeon. So what I do is I mix them all three, and then I'm talking. I don't give a damn who you are. Go see how poor dead. Go say apple day. Oh, you hear that? Okay, you. If it's there, you're still alive. If it's not there, Girl Power team can steal and win the game.
Yes.
So here we go, Eleanor. Name something people do when watching sports on TV.
In Ghana, they bet.
They bet.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Say drink.
All right, ladies, here's the situation we have. Three answers on the board. If you guess either answer, your team wins, your team plays for $5,000. You steal. If it's not there, the KOOMSON family will win the game. Name something people do when watching sports on TV.
Steve, I'm gonna have to say, they be doing some eating and drinking.
This is for the win. They do some eating and drinking. Number five. Number four. Man, y'all played really well. Y'all played really good. Don't worry about that. Y'all played really good. You my girl. Y'all played really well. Hey, I need two of you. I need two of you. I got Angel and I got Nadia. We're gonna play Fast Money, $5,000, right after this. Let's go. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Girl Power family won the game. And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, Nadia, this is how Fast Money works. Angel is off stage where she can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. You can't think of something, you just say pass. We have enough time left, we'll get back to it again. If you and Angel together come up with 200 points, look right there, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
$5,000.
All right, are you ready?
Yeah.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question.
Okay.
Name a superhero that could get you somewhere quickly.
Superman.
Name an occasion where people wear a tie.
Wedding.
A rule a driver would have about their car.
License, seatbelts.
A place where you would find a metal detector.
Airport.
Something you swallow.
Fufu.
All right, let's go, Nadia. Come on. All right, here we go. Name a superhero that could get you somewhere quickly. You said Superman. Survey said. Name an occasion where people wear a tie. You said to a wedding. Survey said. A rule that a driver would have about their car. You said, put on your seatbelt. Survey said.
Oh.
A place where you would find a metal detector. You said, at the airport. Survey said.
Let's go.
Something you swallow. You said. Survey said. All right, Angel, how are you?
Doing good.
Nadia did pretty good. She got 120 points.
Wow.
Yeah, you need 80 points. And Girl Power, walk out of here with $5,000. All right? All right, so this is how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. It's gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Ready.
All right, let's remind everyone of Nadia's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name a superhero that could get you somewhere quickly.
Superman.
Try
Batman.
Again.
Batman.
Name an occasion where people wear a tie.
Funerals.
A rule a driver would have about their car.
Turn left.
A place where you would find a metal detector.
At a concert.
Something you swallow.
Water.
All right, let's go, Angel. All right, let's see. We need 80 points for the money. Name a super people. Name a name. Okay, Steve. Name a superhero that could get you somewhere quickly. You said Batman. Survey said. Number one answer was Flash. Flash. Flash Gordon. We need 71 points. Name an occasion where people wear a tie. You said. To the funeral, survey said. Number one answer was wedding. Wedding was the number one answer. We need 56 points. A rule that a driver would have about their car. You said. All we doing is turning left. We don't do no damn right turns in my car. We only turn left. Turn left. Survey said. Number one answer was no eating. No eating. Here we go. We need 56 points. Come on, we need a couple of big ones. A place where you would find a metal detector. You said. At the concert, you need to go to a different concert. Survey said.
Oh, no.
Airport. Airport was number one. We need 56 points. Something you swallow. You said water. Survey said. Water. Water was the number one answer. Well, ladies, you scored 193 points, so you're walking out here with $4,300. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. Hey, Gordon. Tell him. Hey, hope you had a good time. Yeah, yeah. I need that cake.